takes you down to her place near the river. You can hear the boats go by, you can spend the night beside her.
She's around here somewhere, somewhere here she's hid. Somewhere in a canal by Camden Town, underneath a bridge. That's where he said he put her bits and bobs straight after what he did. Every time I pass the lock, I stop and wonder where she is. You see, Suzanne was quite a looker, quite tasty for a high street hooker. She had a nice shape, nice ass, nice breasts, I guess that's why he took her. But then again, you know what, blood, this guy was kinda mess. So Suzanne's death was probably more to do with torture than it was to do with sex. Nevertheless, he was a sick cunt that ain't no doubt about that. His mental health was in a state, but no one really knew about that, cause he lived alone or on his own and never spoke to neighbours. Plus the guys next door was never home, cause they was always out raving, which made it pretty convenient. Coming to dish that penny weren't lenient. Still no one could hear her screaming when her blood started squirting on the ceiling and drying to the wall till the paint started peeling. And she's cut real bad and still breathing and begging him to stop, but he won't cause he's evil and he ain't about to start reasoning.
Suzanne takes you down to her place near the river, near the river.
It's 10 o'clock on a Friday night. Don't know it, but soon she'll die. She's working the streets like she does every night, pulling in punters left and right. She sees one guy, he says, hard, you wanna fuck? Only if the price is right, Suzanne says with a smile on her face. Screen goes blank, now the back at his place. Back at his place, Suzanne takes off her clothes. Riley makes up a drink in the kitchen. That's what she's thinking when she hears metal objects clinking. Need any help, she says loud and clear. He don't answer her back. He's only in the next room, it's not like he can't hear. Why's it going on like that? Suzanne picks up a tattoo, cover her breasts and on, and goes and sees Wagwan. Suzanne screams, so shocked at what she's just seen. He's holding a knife in his eyes like Brock. She makes a run for the door, but it's locked. Slash, 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 chop, chop, chop. Suzanne screaming, begging him to stop, but he won't stop, and he don't stop, not till she stops struggling. She's lying on the floor in a pool of blood. He goes in the other room to get something.
Dubbed the Camden Ripper, faces life imprisonment after a jury convicted him guilty of all charges. The body of Suzanne Smith, his fifth victim, has still not been found, and police have given up the search. Yes, claims he threw her in the canal after decapitating her head and severing her arms and legs from her torso. Other breaking news today.
So we come to the end of the story. Suzanne died a death real gory, along with a string of other girls he already killed, cause they offered to pleasure him orally. Now banged up, not a threat, now a figure. Last you'll hear of the Camden Ripper. Just of course he escapes, and you better give a second thought about looking around, showing off your figure. After Suzanne, like I said, man, her body parts still never been found. Remember next time you're walking around Camden, look to keep an eye out, cause you might see a piece of her floating by. Scotch on the bridge, smoking weed, getting high. Said she's there and need not lie. Now he's gonna live in jail for the rest of his life.